Es notato. Gli ha detto che è sedetto.
Ma è uno che è qua, ma è uno che è this whole thing's like, and it's not clear that Jesus is no video like
that. Yeah, but come back. Un catacomb, two stones, two stones, and four stones.
Slušajte, stones, 15-10 minutes, four stones, and then not. No. Cijenjena kolega, dobrodien. Šodien mūsu seminārā uzstājas profesors Restovs, īstenībā šis nav seminārs, bet lekcija. Un lekcija, kas būs gan šodien, gan rīt, gan arī nākotnē trešdien, tad trīs lekcijas būs. Par profesoru, es nezinu, cik daudz es varētu vēl pastāstīt, viņš nesen samērā pie mums ir bijis, bet tomēr tie, kuri jau nav apmeklējuši šo lekciju, viņš varētu pastāstīt, tad profesors Restovs, man ir rakstīts angliski, tāpēc es lasīšu tikai angliski, tāpēc viņš sapratīs. He's the head of the Department of Quantum Chemistry at St. Petersburg State University, Russia, from which he graduated as a theoretical physicist in 1916. Research interests of Professor Restov covered the symmetry of crystals, on which he published the monograph, Side Symmetry in Crystals, published in 1993 and 1997. He is interested also in the application of quantum chemistry methods for proper description of perfect and defective crystals, the role of symmetry and quantum chemical study of monoperiodic structures, nanotubes, and nanotubes. In this, he also published two monographs in Springer. He is a foreign member of Latvian Academy of Sciences since 2005, Humboldt Foundation awardee, participant in numerous international and Russian collaborative projects. His publication list includes about 300 papers, indexed to the level of science, and his Hirsch index is 27. Profesors viesosies pie mums.
Nu, paldies, paldies.
Tad nolasīs trīs lekcijas, 2. 3. un 10. maijā. Un šodienas lekcija, kuras nosaukums pagaidām šeit nav, ir symmetric group classification, 3D, 2D and 1D groups, symmetric groups and crystalline structures. So, we have 2 hours lecture, 1 hour, and short break, and another hour.
Labdien visiem! Man tas patīk, ka jūs atnāsāt uz manu lekciju. Tāpēc, ka, kā es saprotu, tagad jau ir brīvi dienas Latvijā, daudz brīvi dienas, un cilvēki aizbrauc uz vasarnīcu, uz siltām zemēm un tā un tā. Nu, un mums ar jums jāstrādā tāmas dienas. Ja? Es domāju, ka latviešu valodā es to nevarētu jums stāstīt, tāpēc, ka es nezinu, kā būs latviski. Band, energy band, and irreducible representation. Bet jūs varbūt palīdzēsiet mani, ja jūsu jautājumi būs latviešu valodā. Ja es viņus nesapratīšu, tad sakiet angļu valodā. No un lecce būs angļu valodā. This is very difficult task for both for you and for me also. Because the main idea is to give you some basis of use of two databases. One of them is crystallography open database, where you can find some information about the crystalline structures which you are interested in. This is one. But to understand the result, you need to know the basis of space groups description, because without this you will not understand. Let's begin from example, strontium titanium. We use this database and put strontium, you see, strontium titanate oxygen. And here, search one to eight elements. Strontium titanate oxygen, as example. And number of distinct elements, minimum and maximum. I'll give in both cases 3, because if I give more, then it will have some mixed systems. I would like to see pure crystal. 3. And then I send it. Send. It gives For example, this. Strontium diagonal. PM 3 minus M. I'm not sure that all who are here now in this room understand what it means. This is a symbol of space group of crystalline solids. This P means that this is simple lattice, and this is crystallographic symbol of point group. So one of first my task is to explain you the symbols for space groups. Second point is file. Or is it? This is another computer. It looks in such a way, strontium diagonal. Here is date of publication and other details, and all 84 symmetry operations. And at the very end of this file, you see the structure: strontium coordinates, titanium coordinates, and oxygen coordinates. 1B, 1A, and 3B. And my task is to explain you all these symbols, because these are symbols of life of positions. So, task is first to explain you just a moment, I'll try to show. You see, symmetry groups classification. Symmetry groups classification you can find on this. This is very nice Bilbao crystallographic server. And you see here space groups, plane groups, layer groups, rod groups, freeze groups, and so on. So, first point in my presentation to explain you all these types of groups. Anatoly told about these books. They are published in Springer, Side Symmetry, and Quantum Chemistry of Solids and Theoretical Modeling. And don't send information to Springer. If somebody is interested, I'll give electronic file, but it's not allowed as it belongs to Springer. So on this slide, you see all types of groups. Dima, help me please, and put the same on this. Molecules. I give here a very simple molecule, iodine, fluorine 5. This is tetrahedral molecule, and all the molecules are described by point groups. Point groups consist of symmetry operations, rotations around axis. This is forceful axis. Reflections in planes. There are four planes, two diagonal planes and two planes orthogonal to coordinate axis, and some combinations of this. So molecules are described by point groups. Next, you see that sometimes in literature when you meet 0D, 1D, 2D, 3D, people confuse this D. This is not the dimension of the system. This is dimension of periodicity. In all cases, the system is three-dimensional. Of course, molecule is three-dimensional, but it has no periodicity. Nanotubes and nanowires this is nanotube. And nanotubes and nanowires, they are 1D systems, but they are also three-dimensional. But periodicity is along the tube axis. In surface modeling, so-called layer groups are introduced. This is 2D, two-dimensional periodicity, but the object is again three-dimensional. And bulk crystals are described by scale group, space group. They are three-periodic. So first idea is not to confuse this the dimension of periodicity and dimension of the system itself. Dima, please help me with this. I'm not sure that you know what is group at all. Therefore, I decided, just one slideshow, I decided to include some information about abstract group definition. But of course, I have no time for group theory explanation, But the main idea is that group is some set of elements which are multiplied, when multiplied, give the element belonging to the same set. In our case, of molecules of crystalline solids, these are symmetry groups. In any case, it means that when we apply at first, for example, one symmetry, rotation or reflection, and then after this next one, we receive also symmetry operation. So first is that in any group, and in symmetry group including, you have some set of elements which form group. Next point is that the multiplication is associative. Of course, for symmetry operations, it is fulfilled. If you at first make one symmetry operation and then the second to multiply left on the right, and then the result doesn't depend on the way in which you apply. For symmetry operations, it's evident. In any group, including symmetry groups, there exist identity element. When you, if you want to connect it with some symmetry operation, then it's a rotation on 360 degrees. This is identity element. And to every element in abstract group, you have a reciprocal element. By definition, reciprocal, it doesn't matter, multiplied on right or on left, gives you identity. So, if you have rotation axis and rotate on 90 degrees and then rotate on 270 degrees, then you have two reciprocal elements. And question to students, what is a reciprocal element to the rotation on 180 degrees? Who knows from students? Reciprocal element to rotation 180 degrees. Andrei, you know, I see.
Itself,
of course. Because when you rotate in opposite direction, you will have the same. So let's consider this example. This molecule, iodine fluorine 5, consists of six atoms. And two of them, iodine, huge one, and small, one of five fluorines, are on the z-axis. And four fluorine atoms form square in the plane, which is orthogonal to this z-axis. So let's try to understand which symmetry operations can be applied to these five atoms, returning the system in the same position. First, of course, you have forced order axis. So you can rotate around this axis by 90, 180, 270, and identity 360. This is order 4 of rotation axis. Then you have 4 fluorine atoms. They are here by Y letter, but it doesn't matter. They are 4 fluorine. They are transformed to each other when you rotate around this force order axis. And the total group consists of how many operations? 4 rotations around the principal axis, including identity 4, and 4 planes, 2 diagonal planes, reflection planes, and 2 coordinate reflection planes. One of them is orthogonal to x axis, and second orthogonal to y axis. So we have a group of 8 symmetry operations. This is symbol of this group is C4V. This 4 means that the rotation axis is 4, and V means vertical, that these planes go through the rotation axis, because in other groups there are horizontal planes which are orthogonal to rotation axis. This is a point group symbol used by chemists, so-called Schönflies symbol, C4V. But crystallographers, and this is difficult because you will see when I'll show the space group list, you will see that there are crystallographic labels for these groups. And they are different from surface, and this is difficult. But it's necessary to understand crystallographic principles also. The order of axes they give simply by figure. 4, 6, 2, 1 is trivial, but in crystals there are no rotation axis, fifth order, because rotation around fifth order axis are not compatible with translations. In molecules, you can have 5 order, 5th order axis and others, but in crystals only 1, 2, 3, 4, and 6. So they give at first rotation axis order, and then M is from mirror, this is reflection plane, but why 2? M and N, because you see that here you have two sets of reflection planes. Two planes are diagonal, and two planes are orthogonal to the coordination axis. And these planes are not connected by symmetry transformation. They are independent. Therefore, crystallographers give M, M. So, in future, we will consider crystallographic symbols, sometimes without any surface symbols. Дима, вы, пожалуйста, сядьте здесь. Now I took from Bilbao server this table. Like of positions of the 3D crystallographic point group. Now you understand C4V what means, 4mm what means, and I give here the picture which we discussed. What crystallographers give? They introduce so-called like of positions, at first for point groups, but also for space groups also. They have chosen the highest symmetry like of position, A, which is 1 in the molecule, and it is a coordinate system origin, and this is over all the operations of this point group, this point is immovable. So this is coordinate system origin, and all rotations and all reflections leave it fixed. So this is 1A. Why it is 0, 0, Z? Do you understand why it's written 0, 0, Z? Who understands what means this Z?
Polar space, point
group. Sorry?
Polar point group.
Yes, because in this case you have whole fourth order axis, and this Z is arbitrary. For origin we take Z 0, for iodine this is 1Z, and for fluorine this is other Z. So this is the whole direction. This like of position, it's very important to understand the symmetry of crystals. This is free parameter of like of position. Not all like of positions in crystals are free parameter, but I'll show it later. So, on this language, crystallography language, our iodine and has 1A position, and our 1 of 5 fluorines have also 1A position. But these Z parameters, these are different. So 1A position is occupied by X and Z, if this is X and this is Z. Is it understandable? Yes? Now about these four atoms. What do you think? Which of two positions, B or C, are occupied by these four fluorines? There are, you see that this is a multiplicity, number of positions in Wyckoff. One, all points on Wyckoff. All the points on this, 1A. One point in Wyckoff position. To understand this very simple example is very important, because for crystals it is more complicated. And therefore, you will see that there are translations. Therefore, when I'll see that you do not understand something, I'm ready to repeat. So, 1A Wyckoff positions, 0, 0, Z, and there are infinite number of positions. For concrete Z parameter values, this is in our molecule. So, you see that fluorine and iodine both occupy 1A position. But there are four fluorines. So it means that one of two of these positions, C4 or CB or 4B or 4C, is occupied by atoms. What do you think? Which one? Don't forget that this is for Z0. Who can say? Andrei, which position, Sasha, which position is occupied by our fluorine atoms? B or C?
B.
B, why?
Because of course.
This is correct answer. He knows group theory. He's a chemist and he knows group theory. Because you see that if coordinate axis is this X and this is Y, then this direction is XX. And this direction is x minus x. And this direction is x 0. And this direction is 0, y. So from these two possibilities, our four fluorines occupy position x, x, z. Because these are only in diagonal planes. Is it clear? So our molecule can be described by a set of Wyckoff positions, 1A, 1A, and 4B. But some other molecules with the same point symmetry are described by some different distribution of atoms over the Wyckoff positions. Every point group is set of symmetry operations, including identity, and it divides the whole space on the systems of equivalent points. And in every point group, there is a point which, so-called general point, in this case, this is 8, multiplicity is 8. This is infinite number of points with arbitrarily x, y, and z. Is it clear, this example? I was thinking how to move to crystals, and I decided to begin from molecules. Is it clear? So, I would like to finish with point groups. I remind that point group describes the symmetry of molecules, 0D systems. For example, water molecule. It has a symmetry group C2V, second order axis through oxygen, and when you rotate around this axis on 180 degrees, then both hydrogens change their positions. So there are the following main types of point groups. Crystalline solids are difficult because in crystals you have both point symmetry and translation symmetry and their combination. And both types of symmetry are important. Therefore, C1, C2, C3, C4, C6, this is simply rotations around the axis of order 1, 2, 3, 4, 6. C2V, this is hydrogen molecule. C3V, C4V, this was our example, and C6V. So CV means, C and V means N is order, symmetry axis order, and V that this the planes are going through this axis, vertical, because it's traditional to take vertical this symmetry axis. Then C2H, C3H, C4H, C6H. H means horizontal. It is orthogonal, perpendicular to the main axis. And now question. You see that he has written C2H, C3H, but here it's written CS. Why? This is CS, and all the rest ones is order axis and plane. Maybe it's not very good quality of slide, but this is CS, simply plane, without any H. Why? If this is 2, 3, 4, 6, then this is 1. But what is 1? 1 is first order axis, no rotation. So any plane which is orthogonal to first order axis is simply a plane which can be oriented arbitrarily. And such group is called CS. And what is CE? CI, excuse me. CI is group consisting of two operations, identity and inversion. Inversion, this is operation which changes x, y, z coordinates of point to minus x, minus y, minus z. This is inversion. In our molecule, which we considered in the preceding slide, there is no inversion. There are no operation which changes coordinates by only by sign. What do you think about water molecule? Is there an inversion center or not? Is here inversion center or not? No, because we have only second order axis and vertical plane. But when appears inversion, when the axis order is even and you have orthogonal plane, then in this case you have both operation applied, it is the same as inversion. If we would have possibility some blackboard, I would explain it more clearly. So next so-called not simple rotations but rotation with reflection S groups. Why I'm giving these symbols in more detail? Because they are used in crystalline symmetry. But the origin of these symbols is from point groups. This is rotations with reflections. What is important? What is the difference between S4 and C4H and C4V? In S4, rotation around fourth order axis is not symmetry operation. Symmetry operation is combined, this rotation with reflection, only this one. But in C4V, C rotation on 90 degrees is symmetry operation, and reflection in the plane is also symmetry operation. D groups, D hedral groups, this is D2, D3, D4, D6. This is symbol of rotation axis, and 2, 3, 4, or 6 second order axis in the orthogonal to main axis plane. D3D and D2D and D3D, the same, but these planes are diagonal. I already told you D2H, D3H, D4H, D6H. And these five groups are important for many crystals because they are called cubic space groups. The symmetry of cube is OH. You will see crystals with this symmetry and I'll explain it in more detail. And tetrahedral group, TD, O group, only rotations of cube without any reflections, TH and T. So these are point groups. And now, how they move to crystalline solids. I took this table from my own book, because you cannot find such table. Crystallographers use these labels. Chemists use these labels. And these are full labels, and these are related labels. But in this table, I try to give all the possible symbols. Let's begin from the group which you know, C4B. This is used by chemists. 4MM, I already explained. In this case, full and abbreviated are the same. Two types of reflection planes. But D2, this is second order axis, and two axes in the plane, orthogonal to this axis. So you have three to order axis. Crystallographers give you 2, 2, 2. And this is short and abbreviated, it's the same. More complicated is D, for example, D4. Fourth order axis and two sets of second order axis in the plane orthogonal to it. Chemists said D4, crystallographers said 4, 2, 2. D2H, this is for orthorhombic crystal system. D2H, this is second order axis, second order axis in the plane, and reflection plane orthogonal to this main second order axis. And this is given in full symbol. Crystallographers use this symbol to say that plane is orthogonal to rotation axis. But when they write this one, they mean that orthogonal axis 3 and plane which goes through this axis. This is V and this is H. And short symbol is this one. Especially difficult are symbols for cubic groups. This is T. These are only rotations of tetrahedra, only rotations. Tetrahedra has order 3 and order 2 axis. But this is already with reflection plane orthogonal to the second order axis. So you see, crystallographers give this full and this abbreviated. Usually in tables you will see the full symbols are not given. It is supposed that people who use tables understand short or abbreviated symbols. So in this case, you have in this table, it's a very useful table, all the possibilities to give symbols of point symmetry. This is a very important moment in my lecture. So I suggest this is next step. Now we move to translations. I finished with point groups. What, which questions you have on points? What was unclear? Silence. What means silence? In Russian, молчание знак согласия. But in English, I don't know what it means. Silence. I wanted simply to give shortly the symbols used for point groups, both in chemistry and in crystallography. And again, here on this slide, you see these symbols. Now you see only abbreviated symbols of point groups and symbols used in chemistry, Schoenfeld symbols. At this moment appears translations. So it's very important to understand at the end, at least of today's lecture, that there is lattice structure and crystalline lattice structure. This is not the same. Lattice is set of points, absolute points. And there are 14 Bravais lattices. And real crystalline structure is connected with some or other type of lattice. And then with distribution of atoms, I'll show this in examples, all with the weight of positions. But now, taking into account translation. So, lattice is set of simple points. But crystalline structure is connected, not only giving that lattice, but also giving the space group, because in with the same lattice there appear several space groups. and different structures for the same space group are connected with different distribution of atoms over the wave of positions. So when you see some structure, I will begin from the perovskite structure, you will see what type of lattice we have, what space group we have, and what is occupation of, by atoms, strontium, titanium, and oxygen, wave of positions. This is a general picture of space groups. And now, lattices. What is important, especially for experimentalists, you need to understand how many parameters you need to describe crystalline structure. Not the lattice, but the whole structure. The number of parameters which you need to describe structure depends on the number of parameters to describe lattice. And then, if necessary, sometimes it's not necessary, to describe the positions inside the primitive unit cell. I'll show all these examples. At the moment, we're speaking only about lattices. Simple cubic lattice. How many parameters you need to describe simple cubic lattice? Only one. This is A. This is length of cube edge, A. What is, maybe for some of you is non-trivial, that body-centered cubic lattice and face-centered cubic lattice also need for description only one parameter, A. But, and this is very important, this is primitive unit cell of cubic lattice. And this is not primitive unit cell. This is so-called conventional unit cell. Because crystallographers like unit cells of lattices, which reflect the point symmetry. For simple cubic lattice, primitive unit cell is also cubic. And therefore, it's accepted by crystallographers as conventional unit cell. But this is two times larger by volume than primitive. And this we will see in the wake of positions description. Crystallographers always consider this one, which is two times larger than primitive, and this one, which is four times larger. Why? Because they like full symmetry. And when I took part in some school in Bilbao, it was 2009, and I considered potassium chloride lattice with space centered cubic lattice. I wrote one potassium and one chloride. And crystallography said, no, it's incorrect. Why? It's necessary four potassiums and four chlorides, because they consider cubic lattice. I explained them that people who make calculations never use crystallographic unit cell. They always use primitive unit cell, because with the primitive unit cell, they can classify the states, electronic or formal states. But of course, in some cases, when you consider, for example, point defects, you need to consider crystallographic cell. So how can we say that this is primitive, this is two times more, and this is four times more? I give lectures in St. Petersburg to chemists, and for them, this idea of translation is absolutely ununderstandable. They know only about molecules. And when I say them that in this cubic body-centered cubic lattice, you have one point, one lattice point belonging to the cube in this corner, and second inside. All the rest ones, cubic corners, belong to other unit cell, because this is unit cell translated over the crystal. So you need to divide between eight cubic unit cells each corner. There are eight corners and eight unit cells around this. So this is two times larger, because you have two lattice points belonging to this conventional cell. This is important to understand. And in the case of Space Center, you have how much? Who can say how much lattice points belong to this conventional universe? What you need to do? You need to see, are there some points inside it? There are none. One point in the corner belongs to this universe. And there are points on the faces. But each face belongs to two unit cells. So you have 6 points on faces, but only 3 of them belong to this unit cell. So this unit cell is 4 times larger than primitive. Is it clear? It's a very important point. Not to confuse conventional unit cell and primitive unit cell. Cubic lattices. Next are tetragonal lattices. What is the difference? In this case, in cubic lattices, you have 3 translation vectors of the same length, and the angle between vectors is 90 degrees. All of them are cubic. In tetragonal lattices, you have the same 90 degrees between all the 3 vectors, but one of them, let it be this one, C, is different by length than 2 others. So in this tetragonal unit cell, you have 2 parameters. More, you can consider again body-centered tetragonal unit cell. So there are 2 tetragonal unit cells, and both are described by 2 parameters, A and C. For example, in some layered systems, layered crystals, the C is very large, and this A is not so large, and I'll give some examples. Next one, hexagonal lattice, anthropohedral lattice. For hexagonal lattice, you have 2 lattice parameters, A and C, and angle in this case was 90, and in this case is 120 or 60. Who knows from chemists why I say 120 or 60? It is the same. Why? In hexagonal lattice, the translation vectors in the plane can form angle 120 or 60. Oh? Andrei, do you understand why? Because when I move from 120 to 60, I simply change the sign of one vector. But of course you understand that if A1 is translation vector, then minus A1 is also translation vector. And you must be careful when you make calculations with this hexagonal lattice. So there are 2 parameters. Rhombohedral lattice also has 2 parameters, 3 translation vectors of equal length and equal angle between them. But this angle is not 60, not 90, not 120. And the most confusing thing for experimentalists is rhombohedral crystal in hexagonal setting. This absolutely confused. Why? What it means? It means that crystal is rhombohedral with rhombohedral primitive unit cell, but crystallographers increase this unit cell. For example, on corundum structure, you will see this conventional unit cell because corundum has rhombohedral primitive unit cell, but crystallographers prefer use hexagonal setting, and then you will see the difference. So 2 parameters in all these lattices. Next one, orthorhombic system. In orthorhombic system, all the angles between translation vectors are 90, but all the 3 have different lengths, A, B, C. Again, but now appears base-centered, body-centered, and face-centered. Who can answer on the question? How many primitive unit cells are inside the base-centered orthorhombic of the Lombic lattice. How many primitive unit cells are inside orthorhombic unit cell basin? How many? Who knows? I show it. Two. Why? Because one in the corner, it always belongs to let it this one, then the rest one do not belong this. And one on the faces, but not on the four faces, on the all faces, but only opposite faces. But this unit cell belongs to unit cells which are connected through the face. So, two times. This is two again, body center, and this is four. How many parameters we need to give for orthorhombic lattice? As the corners are 90 and the lengths of translation vectors are three different. How many parameters? Three. A, B, C. So, one, two, three. Next, monoclinic. Simple or primitive and basic. What is monoclinic system? Monoclinic system. One of translation vectors, it's usually taken along z-axis, is orthogonal to the plane of two others. But the angle between these two is not 90, not 60, not 120, it is arbitrary. This is monoclinic system. So how many parameters you need to give monoclinic lattice? Who knows? Four. Three lengths of translation vectors and this angle in the plane. Four. And the practical no symmetry in triclinic lattice. Alexei, your system, which you showed me on Friday, has triclinic lattice. And here you have six parameters. Any angle between translation vectors, three angles, and any length of them, three and three, six. So one, two, three, four, six. It's very important to understand how many parameters are necessary to give when you describe crystalline structure with some or other type. The same given, excuse me. Dima, different.
No, the same.
The same.
The same.
Different, and this computer is different. Okay, no. When we will have break, we will change it. The same. The same story about lattices, but now we will speak about point symmetry of these lattices. Cubic lattice, as we have seen on the preceding slide, primitive, face-centered, body-centered. All of them are cubic, OH group. This is symmetric group of cube. And why I gave on the preceding slide this picture? This is crystallographer's symbol for OH group. And these are subgroups of this OH. But at the moment when you take subgroup with fourth order, it comes to tetragonal. So maybe I'll explain by other way. Crystallographers have 14 Bravais lattices, but they have only 7 point symmetries of Bravais lattices. Why 7? Because cubic OH, tetragonal D4H, hexagonal D6H, orthorhombic D2H, monoclinic C2H, triclinic S2, but S2 is inversion. In any, as I've already told, if you have translation symmetry, then A1 vector and minus A1 letter have to be, so therefore, there is no lattice, no lattice, but space group can be, which has no inversion. Is it clear or not? These are point symmetries of lattices, 7. Crystallographers call them 7 crystalline systems, or 7 symmetries. But inside any, there are some groups which include are included in crystalline symmetry. And now about parameters. As I already told you, cubic lattice is described by 1 parameter. And 3 translation vectors are given in Cartesian coordinates, A00, 0A0, 00A. This is for primitive. But for face center, you see that this is half. And for body center, this is this one. So these are translation vectors for primitive, face-centered, and body-centered cubic lattice. Lattice parameter is 1. Now tetragonal, excuse me, rhombohedron. In this case, you have two parameters. But what is the difference? When I showed you the rhombohedral unit cell, I told that there are 3 translation vectors with any angle between them. But it is not Cartesian system. But when you write these rhombohedral vectors in Cartesian coordinates, then you have this one. This is it. And it's very necessary to be attentive when you use the space group description. 2 parameters. Hexagonal. Again, you have to be careful. One translation vector is along 6 of the axes, but 2 of them are forming 60 or 120 degrees, and one is taken along Cartesian axis, then second one, as this is not 90 but only 120, has this coordinate. So you understand, I hope, that in this table I give translation vectors in Cartesian coordinates for all the symmetry, for all 14 Bravais lattices. And here I give the parameters. And what is important, that for triclinic system you have ABC parameters, but this alpha, beta and gamma are ordered by crystallographer in the following way. It's very important when you see some crystallographic structure basis data. Alpha is between B and C. Beta is between A and C. And gamma is between A and B. And if you do not know this and read in some crystal structure open data, as I showed you, some crystal with such symmetry, you need to correctly understand the order of these angles. Anatoly, I'm tired. It looks like they are also tired. Maybe we can...
This is 1 hour, so we can...
Okay.
10 minutes.
10 minutes, yes.